Lord Windermere.
I entreat you. People may chatter about her, do chatter about her, of course, but they don't know anything definite against her. She has been to several houses, not to houses where you would go, I admit, but still to houses where women who are in what is called society nowadays do go. That does not content her. She wants you to receive her once.
Lady Windermere.
As a triumph for her, I suppose.
Lord Windermere.
No, because she knows that you are a good woman, and that if she comes here once, she will have a chance of a happier, a surer life than she has had. She will make no further effort to know you. Won't you help a woman who is trying to get back?
Lady Windermere.
No. If a woman really repents, she never wishes to return to the society that has made or seen her ruin.
Lord Windermere.
I beg of you.
Lady Windermere. Crossing to door.
I am going to dress for dinner, and don't mention the subject again this evening.
Arthur.
Going to him. You fancy, because I have no father or mother, that I am alone in the world, and that you can treat me as you choose. You are wrong. I have friends, many friends.
Lord Windermere.
Margaret, you are talking foolishly, recklessly. I won't argue with you, but I insist upon your asking Mrs. Erlynne tonight.
Lady Windermere.
I shall do nothing of the kind.
Lord Windermere.
You refuse?
Lady Windermere.
Absolutely.
Lord Windermere.
Ah, Margaret, do this for my sake. It is her last chance.
Lady Windermere.
What has that to do with me?
Lord Windermere.
How hard good women are.